Five heads of state, top government officials and business leaders attended the opening plenary, and the hosts wasted no time in laying out their pitches.
To extract the real value of continental trade, we need to have the means to produce the goods that we want to trade. We need factories, affordable energy, reliable water supplies, universal broadband and integrated supply chains.
We plan to introduce on this platform innovative technologies that will help to improve transparency, traceability, immutability of records, and integrity of all transactions.
Nigeria's Vice President, Professor Yemi Osinbajo, participated in one of the presidential investment chats where the focus was on reforms and ease of doing business. Nigerian businessman Aliko Dangote, who has businesses across Africa, painted a picture from an investor's perspective.
Now there is rule of law, and I think it is really good for governments and private sector to work together. Because what really discouraged people at the first was all these rampant changes of policies. And sometimes when governments see that you are making money, they are going to change the goalpost and say, no, we don't want people making money.
Away from the Africa Investment Forum venue, Vice President Osinbajo met with members of the Nigerian and South African business community. At the end of that session, we asked him what particular projects Nigeria is placing at the AIF for funding.
One is the Eco Atlantic City project, which, as you know, is one of the major infrastructure and, it's a massive city that's been built there. So it's infrastructure, sites and services, you know, all manner of things. It's a huge, huge project. It's $2.12 billion, you know, and that's here, you know. As a matter of fact, it's being considered right now with all of the investors and everyone sitting around a table trying to work on how this will work, including the FDB. There's also the brass fertilizer and petrochemical project. That's a $3 billion project, which is also, you know, all of these are private, but they are, of course, with, you know, government support. We're here to support those investments.
The vice president is expected to return to Nigeria Friday morning. Meanwhile, still coming up at the Africa Investment Forum are sessions such as financial institutions working together and the business of sports. That's ahead of the closing plenary of the forum. From the Sandton Convention Center, Johannesburg, Betty Dibia, Channels Television News.